Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand some examples on two-dimensional arrays. The concept of arrays, one-dimensional arrays, two-dimensional arrays has already been discussed in our previous videos. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. We are solving these examples under the assumption that you have already watched those videos. The concepts related to arrays you have already watched. Based upon that assumption, we are explaining this this example. So this example is a matrix addition. So what kind of matrix we have taken it is 2x3 matrix, which means 2 rows and 3 columns. We have taken 2 2x3 matrices and 3 2x3 matrices, and these two is to enter the values. And this is to store the sum of these addition, the result of the addition of A and B. So hope you know how to do the matrix addition. Let's take some example and try to recap the concepts. Here A is a matrix, in that for example we have taken 2x3 matrix. It is 2x3 matrix, 2 rows and 3 columns. These are the values in A. Next, B is another matrix, and the values in B are, let's assume that it is, these are the values, and it is also a 2x3 matrix, and the addition of these two matrix, the sum of these two matrix is going to be the result is going to be a 2x3 matrix. And what is the result of the 2x3 matrix is, we are going to take it as C. We are going to take it as C. It is going to be, the indices of these elements are, what are the indices of these elements? It is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, sorry, 0, 2, 0, 2, and next one is 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2. So these are the indices. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2. So after adding these two matrices, it is going to be 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, and 12 plus 6, 18. So this is the result of the sum of these two matrices. So now we'll try to understand each and every bit in a clear way, how the two-dimensional matrices are going to help us in adding two matrices, that we will try to understand. First, we are going to enter the values into matrices A and next matrices B. Then we are going to sum these values, 1 plus 7, 2 plus 8, 9 plus 3. So we are going to sum these values, and finally we are going to print that array. So finally we are going to print that array. So first it is, we have taken two a nested for loop. In that we are going to scan the values, and those values are going to reside, those values are going to be stored in a matrices called A matrix. Okay, matrix A. Okay. So now first the value of I is equal to 0. Initially we are going to start from I is equal to 0, and it is going to iterate 2 times. This loop is going to iterate for 2 times, and the, every time the values of the I in each and every iteration. So first iteration it is going to be 0, and the next iteration it is going to be 1. After that 2 is equal to 2 will happen. So this loop will fail. We are going to come and execute these values, and within this loop we are having another for loop. This loop is going to iterate for 3 times. Every time we come into this loop is going to iterate for 3 times. So those 3 times are the columns, and these 2 times is what we call it as number of rows in the matrix. So it is the first iteration of this for loop, the value of I is equal to 0, and here see here, the scanf, the first I value is 0, and in the first iteration of this inner for loop, the value of j is equal to 0. So the 0 value of the matrices will be scanned, and assume that the value given by the user is 1. In the next iteration, so this has to be iterated for 3 times, the j value is always going to iterate for 0, 1, 2. Wherever the value of j is equal to 3, it is going to come out of that loop. So this loop is going to iterate for 3 times, and the values of j are 0, 1, 2. So in the next iteration of this inner for loop, the value of I is 0, it remains the same, and the value of j is 1. So 0, 1 value will get inserted, scanned, and it will get inserted into the matrices. Next one is 0, 2. So 0, 2, if he has given it as 3, so that will get inserted. So this for loop has come to an end, and here j is equal to 3, j value is equal to 3, 3 is less than 3. Is it true? No, it is not true. We are going to come out of this for loop. Again, this outer for loop will iterate. Now the value of I is equal to 1, and now we are going to come into this for loop, and this loop is going to iterate for again 3 times. Now the values are 1, 0, 1, 1, and the indices of a of ij are 1, 0, 1, 1, and 1, 2. For example, if the user has provided the values as 4, 5, 6, so this complete A matrix has been provided by the user. In the next for loop, in the next statements, this is another combination, nested for loop combination. So in this nested for loop, again we are going to scan the values. Again, the user has to provide the values, and those values will get stored in a matrices called B. Assume that those values are 7 8 9 10 11. Okay, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 values has been provided. So I am not discussing again about that matrices B. So this for loop, in this for loop, the actual addition of the matrices is going to be done. So how that addition is done, that we will check. As the user has given that the matrices A is, the values in the matrices A are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the values in matrix B is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this is the matrices values in matrix B. Now we have to sum up these two, A plus B, matrix A plus matrix B. So how it is going to be done? The 0, 0 value of A and 0, 0 value, the index, I am talking about index, 0, 0 means index. So 0, 0 index of A will get added with 0, 0 index of B, and that result will get stored in 0, 0 index of C. So that is what here this entire equation is stating. So first, what is the value of I? Value of I in the first iteration is 0, and this loop is going to iterate for 3 times. Again, the same logic. So when the value of j is equal to 0, so here I and j values are 0, both are zeros. So in the 0, in the C matrices, C of 0, 0, C of 0, 0 means this is the place. In the C of 0, 0 place, we are going to place A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. So what is the value of A of 0, 0? It is 1, plus B of 0, 0, it is 7. 1 plus 7 will be placed in C of 0, 0. Okay, this is how the addition is done. In the next iteration, the value of j is equal to 1. Now what is the value that we are going to compute? We are going to compute 0, 1, C of 0, 1. So that value of C of 0, 1 has to be stored with the sum of 0, 1 of A, 0, 1 of A, and 0, 1 of B. So these two values has to be summed up. So again, here we are going to give 0, 1 and 0, 1. So I and j, I value is 0, j value is 1. Okay. So now the entire sum of A of 0, 1 is 2, plus next B of 0, 1 is 8. 2 plus 1 is 10, which will get stored in C of 0, 1. In the C of 0, 1 position, this 10 will get stored. Similarly, in the next iteration, the value of j is equal to 2. So I'm not going to explain it. Please try to practice this. So try to do it manually on your own. With that, you will register how the for loops will, in your brain it will get registered how the for loops, nested for loops will work, and how the two-dimensional arrays will work. So those concepts will get digested. So practice the entire program on your own on a paper and pen, using paper and pen, and then write this program and execute it. With that, you will get better understanding. So now the C matrix is going to be C of 0 to index is going to be 9 plus 3 which is 12, and similarly this is going to be 14 and this is going to be 16 and this is going to be 18. Okay, so this is how the C matrix, the values are stored in C matrix. We want to represent in the form of matrix. So for beautification, this part of the program is used. The values of matrices are, so means for better visualization. So already we have given the values of C of J. The values of C of J, C, matrix C has already been stored. Now we will try to display it in the form of matrix. Okay, so for that what we have done is 5D space is taken. Okay, 5D space is taken, and here every time C of ij will get displayed, again the same logic of I and j will get applied. So C of 0, 0 we are going to start and we are going to end with C of 1, 2. So those many times those will get iterated here. So after the first, this is the point that we have to understand, print slash n. So every time this for loop, we are going to complete this for loop, we are going to take a break of one line, and in that line the next values will get iterated. So what happens is with the first iteration of this loop, the value of i is equal to 0, and this loop is going to iterate for 3 times and those values are 0, 1, 2. Okay, so 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2. Okay, so now after completion of this loop, we are going to take a break for one line. So in the first iteration, what happens? C of 0, 0 is 8, 0, 1 is 10 and 0, 2 is 12. After this, we are going to take a break, a line break, in the sense we are going to go to the next line, and again this for loop will iterate, and now the value of i is equal to 1, and this j is going to iterate for again 3 times, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2. Okay, and now the 1, 0, 1, 1 and 1, 2 values are, it is, I think it is 14, 16 and 18. So the values may are correct, I hope so. So this is how the display is going to be. Let's try to execute this program and see how the content will get displayed. Okay, let's try to give the values and check how the output is going to be on our computer. So this is our program. This is the complete program of matrix, the same program that we have seen. So compile it and execute it. So enter the values of matrix A. So the values are, I have given it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The first matrix is provided. The second matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next one is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, sorry, 10, 11, 12, okay, 9, 7, 8, I forgot, I think so. Okay, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so this is how the content will get displayed. In the last for loop, nested for loop, this is how the matrix values will get displayed. So that print new line, we are going to display it in this new line. Okay. So this is a good example for to understand two-dimensional arrays, and it also gives the insight of nested for loops, how the nested for loops are used to store the values of a matrix and how to display the content of the matrix. So that gives us a better understanding of the nested for loops also. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.